Hi all, welcome to Azure Storage Day. This is our session on block storage. My name is Sirius Kutian. I'm a principal program manager on Azure Storage. So in this session, I'll go over how Azure Disk can help address a broad range of your workload needs on the cloud. I will also talk about our latest innovations and show a couple of cool demos. Why is block storage important? As more and more organizations migrate their critical workloads to the cloud, the range of infrastructure requirements, such as performance, durability, and scalability, is also growing. Many of these requirements tie directly to the block storage, which is the foundation for running these mission-critical applications. The type of block storage or disks that you select and configure can impact your workload. Over-provisioning can lead to higher costs, where you're paying for resources that you may not need. Under-provisioning can impact your application performance and may lead to poor user experience. So in a way, any type of suboptimal configurations can impact your cost and performance. So block storage is a key part of your infrastructure, and you may need a range of block storage solutions for running a variety of applications in the cloud. It is also important to make the right storage decision upfront in your cloud journey. Why Azure Disks? Azure Disks are designed to be the most durable, high-performing block storage for virtual machines running mission-critical workloads. I want to highlight a few key reasons why you should choose Azure Disk Storage. First, Azure Disks provide a range of options for cost-effective storage. For example, we offer the lowest cost SSD disks in the public cloud with standard SSD. We also offer capabilities like bursting and performance tiers to optimize costs. I will talk about some of those brand new capabilities later in the session. In terms of reliability, we have consistently delivered industry-leading durability with literally 0% annual failure rate, which means we never lost customer data. We also offer the highest single instance VM SLA in the industry, 3 nines SLA for VMs using Ultra Disk and premium SSD disks. For scalability, with Ultra Disk, you can get up to 160,000 IOPS and 2,000 MB per second throughput, along with sub-millisecond latency for your most demanding workloads. You can also dynamically scale the performance up and down with Ultra Disks. And for security, we offer built-in encryption options to protect your data, including encryption at rest, encryption in transit, and even a double encryption for enhanced security. We also offer private link integration for secure export and import of your data. On top of these, Azure Disk also provide a unique REST API support, which enables ISVs and customers to build truly advanced experience on Azure for scenarios like backup, DR, and migration. It is a really differentiated experience that you cannot get on other cloud platforms. As I was saying, Azure Disk can be used for a wide range of use cases and scenarios. If your workload falls into any of these categories shown here, you can find the right solution on Azure. For example, for your most IO-intensive workloads, Ultra Disk would be the right solution. And for most other generic enterprise production workloads, you could use premium disks. And for cluster applications like SQL FCI, you can leverage our shared disks, which come with full support for clustering. Now, I want to share a couple of examples of how customers are using Azure Disk Storage for running their critical workloads. One customer is Sega. They are a video game developer. They used Azure to expand their popular online multiplayer game called Phantasy Star Online 2 to North America. They are hosting a game server on Azure using Ultra Disks to ensure seamless gaming experience for their users. For them, it is critical to have low latency for storage and ability to dynamically scale performance based on the number of players. With Ultra Disk as the foundation for their game, Sega successfully launched their game in North America and is now available in over 30 countries. Another customer example is Pearson. They are a global computer-based testing company that delivers certification and licensing exams to professionals like nurses, doctors, and IT practitioners looking to get credentials to advance in their careers. Pearson hosts this solution on Azure to remotely deliver exams for their clients. They leverage the performance and flexibility of premium SSD disks. With Azure Disks as their foundation for their critical application, Pearson was able to successfully meet all their contractual obligation to their clients, even as they shifted delivering exams remotely. Azure Disk Storage offers a comprehensive set of block storage solutions for every workload with a wide range of sizes, price points, and performance characteristics, so you can get the exact storage solution you need. For your most IO-intensive and demanding workloads like SAP HANA, Ultra Disk delivers the best performance and offers the unique ability to configure capacity, IOPS, and throughput independently and dynamically scale performance up and down so you can get the optimal performance and cost for your needs. Premium SSDs give you the best balance of cost and performance and is ideal for a majority of your enterprise production workloads. It is also the default choice on Azure. For your other workloads that need consistent performance but is not as IO intensive, we offer standard SSDs as a cost-effective option. It's ideal for workloads like web servers. And for low-cost storage, for things like backup or test development, we offer standard hard disk. Now I want to share with you some of the latest Azure Disk innovations. First, I want to highlight the performance scaling capabilities that Azure Disk offers that may enable you to scale your performance cost effectively. For unplanned scenarios where you need high performance for a short period of time, we currently offer two bursting capabilities, credit-based bursting for smaller disks and virtual machine bursting. Both are suitable for scenarios like improving boot times, processing small batch jobs, and handling unexpected traffic spikes. This is available at no additional cost and is based on credit system where you can burst to peak performance for up to 30 minutes, as long as you have credits available. Bursting allows you to provision your VMs and disks for your baseline performance needs instead of for max performance, allowing you to save costs. We recently announced a preview of on-demand disk bursting. This is a new unique capability on Azure, which allows you to burst your performance much higher and at any time without worrying about burst credits. This feature is applicable to larger disks and is ideal for smoothly handling infrequent and unpredictable high traffic spikes. Now, for example, you have a 1 terabyte disk that occasionally needs a spike to 20,000 IOPS or a 1,000 MB per second throughput. You can do that cost effectively by enabling on-demand bursting. Now, what do you do if you need the high performance for a longer period of time? For example, for an event like Black Friday or for running a performance testing or training environment where you need to maintain the higher performance for a few hours or days. That's where performance tiers come in. We have this great new feature to increase disk performance by going to a higher performance tier for premium disks without increasing the actual disk size. You can lower the tier later when you don't need it anymore. So instead of using a larger disk at a higher cost to meet the peak performance, you can use a smaller disk along with performance tiers, which means you pay for higher performance tier only when you need it. So this helps you lower your costs. And now I will show you a demo of on-demand disk bursting. This is a demo for on-demand disk bursting feature. First, let me show you how to enable on-demand bursting on your disk. It's really very easy. All you have to do is run this simple command on your disk. See the command in the PowerShell window at the bottom. What I'm doing here is setting this new property called bursting enabled to true and applying that on my disk. This is the disk I'm using. Running the command now. you have to execute this command before attaching the disk to the VM. All right, this is done, and you can see that bursting enable flag is now true. What I will do next is to attach this disk to the VM and try out the performance. This is the VM I'm going to use, as you can see in the portal view. Now I'm going to attach our disk to this VM. This is the disk we just enabled bursting, and I'm going to go ahead and hit save. While it's attaching the disk, let's review the disk info here. As you can see, this is a premium SSD disk of 1 TB in size with baseline performance of 5000 IOPS and 200 MB per second. Host cache is set to none. All right, looks like the update is complete now. I have a remote desktop session open for the VM. And as you can see here, the disk that I just attached has come through already here. And now I will run a benchmarking on the disk to check its performance. I'm going to use a tool called IOMeter for running this benchmark. Let me quickly show you the config I'm using on IOMeter. We have many processes pointing to that disk, and I'm planning to run 8 KB random write operations. This is a good configuration for driving high IOPS on the disk. And let me bring up the test results view. This is showing 0 IOPS now, as we haven't started the test yet. Starting the run now. All right, as you can see, the IOPS traffic is now picking up. It's already more than 20,000 IOPS, and it can go all the way up to 30,000 IOPS if we push it. And as a reminder, this is a 1 TB premium SSD disk, normally capable of only up to 5,000 IOPS. Now with on-demand bursting, the disk is able to sustain well above that 5,000 IOPS baseline. Isn't this amazing? And another unique capability for Azure Disks is shared disks. You can attach the same disk to multiple VMs, which gives you a simplified architecture and lower cost. Idea here is that if one VM becomes unavailable, another VM can seamlessly take over the workload. Azure Disk Storage is the only shared block storage in the cloud today that supports both Windows and Linux-based clustered or high availability applications with full support for clustering using SCSI persistent reservation. This enables you to easily migrate your clustered workloads like SQL FCI or Windows Server cluster or Linux cluster environments to Azure. Shared disk is supported on both premium SSD and Ultra disks, so you can get a balance of price and performance based on your needs. Another unique capability we recently announced is the preview of zone redundant storage for Azure disks. Typically, block storage solutions use a locally redundant storage, LRS, where we use multiple replicas within a single zone or a data center. Now, you have a second option for redundancy, to use ZRS, which spreads the replicas across three different zones in a region. ZRS disk can provide protection against outages that can affect a whole data center, though it's very rare. Now imagine using ZRS disk in a shared disk configuration, attaching the same ZRS disk to VMs in three different zones, providing your workload with the ultimate protection for high availability. I talked about premium disk performance tier earlier and how you can leverage that feature to provision higher performance to meet your increased workload needs. Now, I want to show you a preview of what's coming next. Wouldn't that be nice if you can upgrade the premium disk performance tier without disrupting your production workload? Let's take a look. This is a demo for live update of disk performance tier. Let me show you how it's done. This is the VM I'm going to use for this demo. As you can see, it's a running VM. Let's look at the disks next. I will use this one data disk on the VM for this demo. And as you can see here, it's a premium SSD disk of size 128 gig, which is a P10 disk capable of 500 IOPS and 100 MB per second throughput. A typical real life scenario will be that you have a workload running on this disk and the workload may have grown over time. And so you need a higher performance from the disk, or you have a seasonality with the workload and you expect to need a higher performance for a period of time. You can do that easily now with a live update feature without disrupting the workload running on the VM. I will use this command you can see in the lower part of the screen for doing the live update. This is our disk and I'm going to try to set it to P30 disk. Let me execute this command now. It will take some time to run, and once it completes, the tier will change to P30, capable of 5000 IOPS and 200 MB per second throughput. Live update feature is currently in preview, and I'm using a template deployment method here for executing this command. We will be adding other ways to do the live update, including portal UI, PowerShell, and CLI support. Okay, the update is complete now. Let's look at the disk tier next to verify it. I'm going to run this command to show the tier of this disk. All right, the new tier is now showing P30 after we did the live update. Until now, we talked about how to use Azure Disk Storage with Azure Virtual Machines. I want to share that we are working on extending that to include other host solutions as well. As you may know, VMware solutions running in the cloud today cannot use the regular persistent block storage on any cloud platform. Very soon, we will be announcing support for using Azure Disk with VMware solution. We are super excited about offering this unique experience for Azure VMware solutions. Stay tuned for more details, and you can sign up for preview using the link shown here. In addition to the native Azure platform capabilities we talked about, we also have a rich ecosystem of partners that offer solutions built on Azure across many categories, including migration, backup and DR, container management, and SAM. Some of them are shown here. And finally, to learn more about Azure Disk Storage, please check out the resources listed here. We have great content and documentation for you to explore in more details.